Curious why the cops showed up? Well, here is a little hint. What's going on, everybody? My name is Jeremy. Welcome to my channel. Today I am diving a new spot on the river. I've actually went north a few miles to a new bridge. Never dove this spot before. First time I think anybody's dove this spot before. One, it's no swimming allowed. So we have to be super secretive about this spot because I don't want to get a ticket. Who knows what I'm going to find in these waters, but I guarantee it's going to be epic, whatever it is. So stay tuned and make sure you stick around to the end of the video so I can show you everything that I found. I am super excited about this spot. My adrenaline is flowing. So let's get suited up and let's get in this water and see what we can find. This little white jar actually dates back to the 1930s. Somebody's being naughty. I definitely didn't plan on finding this today. It looks like it's been sitting down here for a long time. How long do you think it's been sitting down here before? Comment down below. Pretty hard to see what this is right now, but wait till the end of the video and I'll show you. I'll give you a little hint. It has something to do with other scuba divers.
good.
It's really strange finding a big silver ring like this laying down here in the middle of the river. It was still a really awesome find, though. And meltdown in 3, 2, 1.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh shit! Yeah! Oh! That is so old!
There is definitely something inside this jar that's not supposed to be in here. I can't wait to get home and crack this thing open so we can see what's in it together. There's something inside that jar. It's got a lid on it. Please let it be coins or something amazing. Let's get out of the water and find out what that is. All right, that was an amazing dive. I found so many things. Let's check out some of the stuff that I found. Let's start with this ring that I found.
That is a big man ring right there. Sterling silver, not a bad find at all. Found more change, awesome. This coin is not like the others. I can't quite tell what's on it, but I'm gonna clean that one up and maybe post it on Instagram.
Okay, so there were bottles everywhere, and I did not want to make a bottle finding video, but I did collect a few bottles I wanted to show you. I found this one. The reason I kept it is because it's very unique looking and definitely looks old. I found not one, but two half-pint milk bottles. I found this one online. It says Roden Dairy Products. It's been selling online for like 30 bucks, so that was a pretty good find. And I found another one that doesn't have any writing on it whatsoever. So I kept these two, but the whole river was littered with these bottles. So if you want to go hunting with me with bottles in this river, just give me a call and we'll get in the river and find as many as you want. I also found this one, white, no writing on it whatsoever. I thought I was the first person to dive this spot of the river. I was wrong, and they left proof.
I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's like a little keychain or some kind of little trinket that says Divers Academy on it. It's really hard to read on the other side, but it says aim high, dive deep. How cool is that? A diver must have dropped that in the same spot I was in. Check this out. It is a Hindu copper statue. I found this right off the bank. I believe it is the Hindu goddess Shiva.
So I cracked open the two jars that I found at the bottom of the river. The littler one of the two ended up having lots of herbs and spices and some oils inside it. It smelled horrible. It actually made me gag and I had to hold it back. I did end up finding three notes that was inside the jar that had people's names written on them. I did a little research online and found out that this is kind of a Wiccan prayer jar. The other jar, the bigger jar, was not so pleasant. Once I cracked that open and dumped it out, I realized that the liquid inside was actually vinegar and there was rocks and a shredded picture. I put the picture back together and I found out that it was a picture of a young lady whose name apparently was Lauren, because that is what was written on the back. Three times. I ended up finding two guns also at the bottom of the river that I got to keep and bring home with me. The first one is this little starter pistol. I did a little research online and found out that this could possibly date back to the 40s. This one still actually has the cartridge in it. The other gun that I've found is a Model 22K revolver. I couldn't put an exact date on it, but it does go back. I found one place online that was auctioning one of these off, obviously in better condition, for around $50. The cops looked at these and determined that they're not going to be able to do anything with these guns, so they let me bring them home, which is really awesome. This is the first guns that I got to bring home. This was an amazing dive. I cannot wait to go back to that section of the river. Make sure you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Like this video if you liked it. Dislike this video if you disliked it. Until we meet again, my name is Jeremy, and I hope you have an amazing day.